The Wild West, also known as the Old West, is well known all around the world as fighting with Indians, shooting up saloons, and getting into Old West showdowns. But evidently that is not true. Here are a few myths about the Wild West that you may still believe in today. Myth: settlers were constantly clashing with Indians. The myth says that Old Westerners treated Native Americans with hate. Ambushes could come from anywhere at any time. An expedition came with the warning that you'd better go with your guns. When a wagon train saw a raid of Cherokee or Sioux coming, they would circle the wagons to form a defense perimeter. Reality: Native Americans and Westerners did not fight as frequently as myths say. It was far more likely that the settlers would trade with Native Americans or hire members of various tribes as guides rather than fight them. Myth: cowboys are an American creation. One reason Americans have always been in love with the Old West is that it's so distinctly American. Or is it? The more of a cowboy you are, the more of an American you are. Even Teddy Roosevelt got in on the act by calling himself the cowboy candidate. Reality: cowboys weren't an American invention at all. The original cowboys were Mexican cattlemen known as vaqueros, and they are literally everything you can imagine a typical cowboy to be. Vaqueros were horsemen and cattle herders from Mexico. The vaquero traditions developed in Mexico also became the foundation for the North American cowboy.
Prostitution in the West. Soiled doves were the first kinds of women in the prostitution business in the Wild West. They were often young girls that would run away from their families in order to start a new life. Many of these women would live in prostitution houses known as bowdy houses. They worked in numerous brothels, parlor houses, and various western houses and cribs. When the women did not stay in their houses, they would travel in cat wagons, which are mobile prostitution homes where they would visit travelers and soldiers along the way. Other nicknames included Doves of the Roost, Daughters of Sin, and Sporting Women. There was a difference between soiled doves in general and soiled doves that worked in saloons. The two types of bad girls in the West were those who danced in brothels and parlor houses and saloon women. A saloon girl's job was to make the older males in the saloon feel better about themselves in any way possible, whether it meant talking, dancing, or other types of entertainment. The girls had to do it. Most of the saloon girls ran away from farmhouses or mills, while the other dancers in parlors and brothels worked there for strictly dancing purposes. At the time, saloon girls wore brightly covered ruffled skirts that were very short for their time period, going down to only the knees. Prostitution was a booming business in the West when it first started and stayed very successful all throughout the Wild Western period. Spaghetti Western films were movies made by Italian and Hispanic actors that were based off of facts and folk tales they heard about. The spaghetti western period started in the early 1960s and did not end until the late 70s. The majority of the actors were Italian, however, actors from Germany and Spain also participated in the films. The movies had much more violence than in regular American western films. There were many fights, shootouts, and other fascinating confrontations during these classics. The settings of these films takes place in American and Mexican border territories as well as Native American territories. 1966 through 1968 were considered the glory days of the spaghetti western films. During this three-year span, most of the classic western films were made. An example of one of these films is The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly by Sergio Leone. In this spaghetti western film, three money-hungry men go to the West in search of large amounts of gold, but each of them attempts to double-cross each other in order to have the entire amount of money. After violent encounters with other money-hungry migrators, the three have to work together in order to get the gold. Sergio Leone was one of the more famous producers of the spaghetti western films, making half a dozen films during his career. Another movie made by Leone was Once Upon a Time in the West, and another made by Leone was also produced by Endo Barboni called They Call Me Trinity. Finally, one of the last eras of the spaghetti western films was the Twilight series, which were dead serious and dramatic films, usually resulted in a tragedy and dramatic ending for one of the main characters.
Motivation for Western migration. Many were farmers, cattlemen, and homesteaders who went west to build a ranch or farm in this new land. The emigrants also included tradesmen, businessmen, journalists, adventurers, missionaries, gamblers, and miners. They were motivated for many reasons. On the other hand, African American slaves traveled west to get their freedom. Runaway slaves were granted freedom if they made it to the new western lands. There they could start a new life as farmers or loggers. By May 1848, a few hundred gold seekers came to California. By the end of the year, they numbered in thousands. Before long, people from throughout the United States and other countries came to California hoping to strike gold and eventually become rich. Why don't we take a look at this lucky miner who struck some gold today?
Savage, come here, I think we got something.
We got ourselves some golden nuggets.
By the end of the gold rush, more than 300,000 people had migrated to California. The gold seekers were called 49ers for the year 1849, when the gold rush was at its peak. Not everyone who came to California wanted to work in the gold fields. Many men and women came to start businesses. Some came to sell clothes, some came for food, others ran hotels and other jobs. The gold rush lasted just 4 years. By 1852, 49ers had mined gold worth more than $80 million. Finally, many settlers wanted to go west because they believed America was meant or destined to expand to the Pacific Ocean. This belief was called the Manifest Destiny. Manifest Destiny is the idea of expanding from coast to coast. This painting by John Gast is the most famous painting that deals with Manifest Destiny. It is a representation of the modernization of the New West. It shows the majestic lady leading civilization westward with American settlers and a telegraph wire. The different stages of economic activity and transportation are shown as well. Now, what's a project on the Wild West without a homemade duel? Huge thanks to my brother's friends Colin Lurch and Mike Saratella for reenacting this. Hope you enjoy.